you would have gone with a group of your friends, you always would have done that outing. Now what happens at that time? Suppose if someone sees a beggar or a beggar is behind you, you would have seen how your friends react to him in a different manner. Someone would not like him, someone would promptly take out money and give it to him. So this is nothing but the attitude you have towards a beggar. So let's understand what attitude plays a role when it comes to an entrepreneur. See, attitude is an important psychological attribute of individuals which shape their behavior. As I give you an example, some people don't like beggars and they promptly start shouting at them. So that is because of this attribute of individuals which has shaped their behavior. Over the years, they would have learned from their surroundings and they have that disrespect for beggars. So attitude is nothing but a psychological attribute. So the way a person would feel about something, let's say another person or a place, a commodity or a situation or an idea, defines the attitude of the person. The features of attitude are, remember, it affects the behavior. So attitude can lead to an intended behavior if there is no external intervention. Invisible. I cannot touch attitude. I can only see. You can suppose, let's say one of your friend is totally allergic to beggars, and the moment she sees them, she starts yelling at them. So the behavior here is affected. You can see that she is not required to shout, but then she's shouting on that beggar. Unless and until there is an external intervention, that means unless and until one of you, that is either you or one of your friends, intervene and says, no, this is not a right behavior. Now you can only see her behavior, you cannot touch it. So attitude is invisible. Now attitude, remember, is learned over a period of time. It doesn't come in one day. Over time we have develop a certain kind of attitude towards, let's say, life, people, society, government, etc. So generally it starts from childhood, the moment we are born, and we start learning things, and it continues lifelong. Remember, till the time we are alive, we keep on experiencing things and our attitude changes accordingly. As I had told you earlier, parents play a very important role when it comes to values as well as when it comes to developing a certain kind of attitude in child. Now, they are formed in the process of socialization and may relate to anything involved. For instance, a person may have positive attitude towards something, whereas he would have a totally negative attitude towards something else. For example, he would have a negative attitude of people belonging to a certain caste, or he would have a negative attitude towards politicians or certain countries. Now, what are the sources of attitude? See, first is the direct personal sources. So your parents, your friends, they become the direct personal sources. Group associations. There are several groups, including your family, work, peer groups, cultural, subcultural groups, all these which you join or you are part of it, they all become an influencer and they affect your attitudinal development. Now, sometimes what happens is you get influenced by others. So, for example, a consumer's attitude is formed or changed through personal contact with influential persons. Now, you would have seen, like many a times when an advertisement is placed in the, when an advertisement comes on a TV, what happens, you would have seen a famous actress coming and selling that product. So why she has been roped in? Because she has the ability to influence the people who would have a liking for her. Similarly, if you have any kind of friends who are famous, who are well respected in society, you will get influenced by them and have an attitude which they have. Even relatives, experts are examples of that. Now, let's understand the essentials, that is, essential attitudes which an entrepreneur should have. It is necessary an entrepreneur should have the right attitude, otherwise his business would suffer. So first thing, he should have a passion for business. He should be trustworthy. I gave you an example of the shopkeeper wherein I was cheated. I was being charged more than the MRP. Okay, and he convinced me that he was right. So he lost the trust at that time. The moment I came to know I was cheated, I lost the trust and I would not go back to him. So being as an entrepreneur, being trustworthy is important. He should be flexible to change. Change is constant. Remember, everything else may not happen, but then change keeps on happening in our life. So change is constant, and hence flexible to change is necessary, but then the core values should not be compromised. So you shouldn't compromise on your honesty just because you want to change or you want to compete with your competitor. You shouldn't, as an entrepreneur, fear of failure shouldn't hold you back. So this should be one of the attitude, that is a positive attitude, that no matter what, even if I fail, I'll keep on trying. You should make timely decisions. The time is the most important factor. If I see a need today, I need to act and develop a product accordingly. If I do that after 5 years, chances are the product would be a failure because someone else would have already come into the market with a similar product. I should maintain a work-life balance. See, if you keep on working, it will not really help you. So maintaining that work-life balance and ensuring that personal life is also important and it's given the right time is necessary. You need to keep your ego in control. You cannot say, I earned X amount of money, let's go and spend it, and then forget about the future. So keeping the ego in control becomes necessary. Believing in self is necessary. Encouraging and accepting criticism from others is very important because it helps you to grow. Maintaining strong work ethic is again a necessity and an attitude which every entrepreneur should have. You should rebound quickly from the setbacks. You will keep on receiving setbacks. You should have the ability to bounce back. And you should regularly get out of your comfort zone